Okay, so we have seen exercise 12.1 in the early stages. Okay, so today exercise 12.2. So what is the first question? If A and B are mutually exclusive events. So these units very very simple because probabilities. So if A and B are mutually exclusive events. Mutually exclusive events A and B are okay, and then P of A is equal to 3/8, P of B is equal to 1/8. Then find these four subdivision. P of A, which means what? Probability of A, and then P of B means probability of B are given. So what is the first question? We have to find out P of A bar. So first of all, write down what is given. P of A given, P of B given. What is the first question? Find out P of A bar. Okay, so P of A bar is equal to, this is a formula, so I can write. Okay, so P of A bar is equal to, I can write 1 minus P of A. Okay, so 1 minus P of A value what? 3/8. So cross multiplication you will get 1 8s are 8, 8 minus 3 5. So 5/8, that's your P of A bar. That's it. 5/8, your P of A bar. Okay. So how to find out P of A bar? 1 minus P of A. So how to find out P of B bar? 1 minus P of B. That's it. Now second question. Find out P of A union B. Find out P of A union B. How? This is a formula. Look at that. A and B are mutually exclusive, which means what? Okay, therefore this is from P of A union B is equal to P of A plus B of B. So mutually exclusive. So we know that formula. What is the formula? Exact formula is A union B is equal to A plus B minus A intersection B. But here mutually exclusive, therefore no common term, which means no common term. So this must be 0 only. So I did not take this one. Okay, I simply take A plus B only. That's it. Okay, don't get confused. So P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B. Okay, so this is a formula. P of A value 3/8, we know that. P of B value 1/8, we know that. So and then 4/8, and then you will get the 1/2 answer. Okay, but usually in the formula we have here minus P of A intersection B, but this is mutually exclusive undranala we can't, okay, we don't need to write this one. And then P of, what is the second question? Third one, P of A bar intersection B. P of A bar intersection B. Okay, so this is a way to find out P of A intersection B. So P of B, we know that we have to know that. And then P of A intersection B, we know that. We have to know that. How to find out P of A intersection B? Yeah, so I already said that in that formula, normal usually formula, we have A intersection B here. If I have to find out P of A union B, na, I just take left hand side P of A union B. Either find button, na, either took it on the ingabonu. It will be coming to here. That's it. Look at that. P of A intersection B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A union B. P of A value we know that 3/8. P of B value we know that 1/8. Minus P of A union B, just now we found that 1/2. After solving, you will get 0. Because we know that mutually exclusive, which means what? No common term. Okay, randomly common term kadiyade. So it must be 0 only. So it must be 0. So you don't need to write this one also, because since mutually exclusive, therefore no common term. Yeah. Now P of B value 1/8 minus P of A intersection B value 0. So 1/8 minus 0, you will get 1/8. That's it. And then P of A bar union B bar. Okay. Yeah. So this is from De Morgan's law. D Morgan's law. What is the D Morgan's law? A dash union B dash, which is equal to A intersection B whole dash. Okay, D Morgan's law. Like that, I can write P of this term. P of this term, I can write P of A intersection B whole dash. A intersection B whole bar. Yeah, you can write it there, whole bar. Okay, and then whole bar, which means what? P of A bar, how to find out P of A bar? 1 minus P of A. P of B bar is equal to 1 minus P of B. So P of A intersection B whole bar is equal to 1 minus P of A intersection B. That's it, yeah. So 1 minus P of A intersection B. P of A intersection B what? A intersection B, which means A kum B common another. What does it mean common? B is exclusive, there is no common term. So it must be 0. So 1 minus 0, which is equal to 1. That's it. This is the first one. And then question number 2. If A and B are two events associated with a random experiment for P of A is equal to 0.35, P of A or B equal to 8.5. So the 8.85 and P of A and B is equal to 0.15. Find all the terms. Okay. So first of all, what are the things? First of all, every problem you should write what are the data given in the question. Okay. P of A given. So I just write. Here R. R means what? R means union. And means intersection. Keep in your mind. Okay. So remember, R means union and means intersection. Union means we have to combine together. Intersection means we have to find out common. Okay. Okay. So what is the first question? P of only B. P of only B. So in the every problem, this one formula must be used. P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. Edna moon value, if we know any three value, we will find the other one. Just that's it. Okay, now look at that. What is given? P of A given. Substitute P of A here. P of A union B given. Substitute P of A union B value here. P of A intersection B given. Substitute P of A intersection. Remaining term is P of B. So usually just found out. Yeah, that's it. Okay, this formula is very, very important. Not only for the probability in the set. If you take sets, this problem is very, very important. But in the set, we don't take P of. We take number of. Okay, we are taking number of. Number of A union B. Yeah, like that. Okay. So substitute and then substitute and you will get the answer. P of B value 0.65. What is the second subdivision? P of B bar. Yeah, now tell me how to find out P of B bar. Like previous sum. P of A bar means how to find out 1 minus P of A. So P of B bar means how? 1 minus P of B. That's it. So what is the value of P of B? We just found out 0.65. So 1 minus 0.65. What is your answer? 0.35, I think. Yeah, 0.35 only. Yes, look at that. 0.35. Okay. Okay, and then what is the third condition? P of only A. P of only, so already the given, the question is P of A given. Also, enna solranga, find out P of only A. So, same formula. So, in this formula, now substitute here value. P of B value is 0.65. P of A intersection B value is 0.15. And then you will get P of A value. That's it. Okay, a die is thrown twice. Let A be the event, first die shows 5, and C be the event, second die shows 5. Find P of A union B. Okay, so P of A union B, find out. So what is the formula? What is the formula? You should know that Yeah, the same formula. P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. Yeah, so what is the formula? We know that P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. If you want to find this value, P of A union B, you should know that P of A value, P of B value, P of A intersection B. So that's what we are going to find out. Okay. So now look at that. A die is thrown twice. Twice means if you toss one die, you will get six outcomes. Okay. Either 1, either 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At a time, two dice are twice are the bottom of the how many you get? 6 square, which means 36. Okay, 36. Okay, what is the, let A be the event, first die shows 5. Let A be the event, first die shows. So, what are the possibility? What are the possibility? Okay, suppose if you assume that in your hand two dice are there. Okay, rent dice from the left. So in the right hand, first dice, left hand, second dice. What is our question? Let A be the event, first die shows 5. So your right hand die only shows the 5. Left hand die only enna venalum kaatalam. But what are the possibilities? Okay, if you throw two dice, in that first die you will get 5, but in the second die either you will get 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6. Okay, so in the first die you should get 5, but in the second die you can get whatever, so that is okay. So in the first die la mattum dhaan 5 varanum, second die la enna venal varalam. So how? Okay, first, yeah, you throw it the two dice. So in the first die you will get the 5, you definitely get the 5, but in the second die you will get first of all one value. So one kadachirukku appadina 5, 1, and then 5, 2. If you get the second 5, 2, and then you will get 3, you will get 4, you will get 5, you will get 6. So total A outcomes are, so what are the possibility? These are the possibility. So this is a A value. Okay, I have to find out P of A value. So if you want to find the P of A value, you should know that number of A divided by number of S. Number of A divided by number of S. Number of A means what? In the A outcomes, how many values we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 value. That is the number of A. Number of S means in the first line, look at that. The dice is thrown twice. So 6 is square, 36. That is the number of S. So number of A divided by number of S, you will get the 1/6, correct? That is a P of A. Now tell me P of B. So B value, what are the outcomes? B the event, second die shows 5. So same method, assume that two dice in your hand. First dice, ipa edhu venal kaatalam, but in the second dice only, that must be show 5. The second, what are the possibilities? Yeah. Up the opposite of this one. So 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, and then 6, 5. Because this is the first die, this is the second die. In the second die, I must have 5 all the tasks. Ella task le enak first second task la 5 varanum. But in the first die, I will get anything, whatever it will show, you can take it. So and then once you find out B value, what is the first step you have to do? Number of B, you must know that. Number of B mean counting and then tell me 6 value. After finding number of B, you can find out P of B value. So P of B is equal to number of B divided by number of A, 6/36, 1/6. Now A intersection B. I have to find out A intersection B. Because in that formula, P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So I have to find out A intersection B also. So look at that A and B, is there any common term? here 5,1, this is 1,5 different, 5,2, 2,5 different, different, but 5,5 is same. So A intersection B value is 5,5. So number of A intersection B, how much? 5,5. That's only one term, only one term at another. So how to find out probability of A intersection B? Number of A intersection B divided by number of A's. So 1/36. So after find out all the value P of A, P of B, P of A intersection B, substitute in that formula. So you will get after, this is a 1/6, this is a 1/6. So 1/6 plus 1/6, 2/6, minus here 1/36. And then cancelling 1/3, and then you will get 1/36. So after cross multiplication and then subtraction, you will get the answer. Or simply you can 6/36, totally 12/36, minus here 1/36. 36, denominator common, 12 minus 1, 11, so 11/36. Okay, now the probability of event A occurring is 0.5, A occurring 0.5, B occurring 0.3. If A and B are mutually exclusive events, okay, suppose they mention, what is mentioned? Probability of event A, which means what? P of A given. But otherwise in the previous sum, they just tell me A be the event. Here there is no mentioning anything probability. Probability is mentioned manala. Okay. So we have to find out probability of B, probability of A. But in that question, they mention given that probability of event A. So which means what? P of A is given. No need to find out P of A. So P of A is 0.5 and P of B is 0.3. If A and B are mutually exclusive events, mutually exclusive, which means what? Which means no common term, yeah. No common term. That means intersection value 0. Okay, so A kum B kum intersection value 0. P of A intersection B is 0. Number of A intersection B is equal to 0. Find the probability of first question, P of A union B. Enna pannala? P of A union B. Yeah, that's it. So write down the formula. P of A union B formula. What is the P of A union B formula? P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So you should know that P of A value, P of B value and P of A intersection B value. P of A value given, P of B value also given. But P of A intersection B, which means mutually exclusive events, which means no common term, intersection term 0. So you just substitute 0, or you no need to write that P of A intersection B. You no need to write that P of A intersection B. So and then substitute, you will get the P of A and B. And then P of A intersection B bar I want. So this is a formula. First of all, find out P of A intersection B. P of A intersection B, we know that 0. And then this is what we have to know that. So P of A minus P intersection B. P of A value we know that 0.5. Minus P of A intersection B value is. Okay, this is also method to a formula to find out this one. So you know that, okay? And then substitute, you will get the answer.